Many pharaohs built temples here, marking the stone with their name to proclaim their power. But not all these boastful marks are quite what they seem. Egyptologist Erica Fellig has spent 7 years studying the enormous hypostyle hall. She's looking for clues to the architect of the largest temple on site.
I love the detective story. I love figuring out what happened to this column before it ended up looking like it does today.
Incredibly, her seemingly simple task of identifying who built this massive temple has uncovered a remarkable story of high politics and royal vanity. The Hypostyle Hall is a gallery of ancient artwork. All 134 columns were once adorned with inscriptions from top to bottom. Every inch of stone told a story in vivid color. The markings boast of the godlike status of one man, a pharaoh whose symbol adorns the columns at every angle. Plastered all along the main avenue is the mark of Ramesses II. Ramesses II is nicknamed the Builder. This powerful pharaoh reportedly constructed more major buildings and statues in Egypt than any other king. But although his mark covers the Hypostyle Hall, Erica suspects that Ramesses could be taking credit for the work of one of his predecessors. Today, she uses new technology to record the carvings and search for clues. This is a task that previous generations of archaeologists were unable to pull off.
The columns have never been recorded in detail, and that's mostly because of their enormous size. Traditional methods involved using transparent plastic sheets to trace over the figures. Because of the heat, the light, the gravity, all that plastic sheeting would have sagged, so we would have had distortions.
Instead of tracing the images, Erica uses photography and special software to reveal the smallest details hidden inside the carvings. She directs photographer Owen Murray to take the images.
I am photographing these columns, trying to get as high definition and high fidelity an image as possible. The major challenges that we're facing with these columns are height and consistency of light.
The marks Erica hopes to see are so faint, they can only be photographed in very precise shaded lighting. This gives Owen only a small window to work each day.
We're dealing with the position of the sun as it moves throughout the day and trying to keep consistent with the quality of photograph. And that has been one of the bigger challenges. Up until this point, we haven't really been able to do that.
Owen takes hundreds of photos of the shaded column with an overhead light. This technique helps him to capture every detail of the carved stone surface. Erica then uses advanced 3D modeling to stitch Owen's photographs together. She then unrolls the curves into a single flat image. Now she can carefully analyze the stone surface, hunting for the remains of old inscriptions, scrubbed out and recarved with the name of Ramesses.
There are times when we'll take a photo and it's only after 2 weeks once we process it or play with the lighting that we realize, oh, we actually captured something that looks like a recarved inscription. If you look closely, you can see traces of what used to be the outlines of some of the hieroglyphs that were part of that initial decoration.
Erica believes these faint scratches, hidden beneath the main inscription, are the scrubbed-out remains of another pharaoh's mark. Once Erica identifies the overwritten text, she checks it out in real life. She uses mirrors to manipulate the daylight to help the faint carved lines stand out.
So the two large ovals you can see contain the names of Ramesses II. And behind them, you can still see the outline traces of, say, the first.
At key points in the hall, especially along the grandest and most visible central walkway, Ramesses' name overwrites that of his own father, Pharaoh Seti I.
And you can still see the faint traces towards the left side of the Ramesses II.
Ramesses was desperate to replace his father's name with his own. But the old pharaoh had made his son's deception almost impossible to pull off. Ramesses' father was an art connoisseur. His carvings were elaborate, with deep outlines and raised figures. So when Seti died and Ramesses took the throne, the new pharaoh faced an uphill task to erase the memory of his predecessor. Ramesses erected scaffolding around the pillars. He chopped the raised images off, but he still couldn't get rid of the deep outlines. In his haste, he scraped his name on top in simple sunk relief carvings. Finally, he used a thin layer of plaster to conceal the faint traces of his father, which the weathering of time has only now revealed.